It working? Okay. Hi guys, and welcome to the new and highly anticipated Life is Strange Before the Storm. Yes, is a new game made from the guys at Square Enix, and it's you know, on the same story of Life is Strange, just that this one, you know, it's a an actual prequel to the story of Life is Strange. You're gonna play, from what I've seen in the trailer, and I'm very excited to play it. I really love the Life is Strange, and I'm very excited to play this one out. You are going to play as Chloe in the time, like, before Max arrived to Arcadia Bay and, you know, all the shit and the time traveling started. And it's gonna be interesting. I can't wait to play it out, but you know, it's interesting because, like, the main purpose, the main idea of Life is Strange, even though it was a spectacular story game, the main thing about it was that you as Max had the ability to, you know, revert time, you know, had this, like, weird power that you discovered to, like, revert time and, you know, redo your decisions, even though in the grand scheme of things not much has changed except for, like, the last decision at the end. But now, you know, Chloe doesn't have that power, so we have the same, you know, story game, but we don't have, like, the main piece element of it. So that's, you know, that's gonna make the game feel a little strange, but at least, you know, we know that our choices are permanent, if you want to put it that way. Also love, like, the anarchy sign behind that. So, you know, we're gonna see how Chloe got to where it got until then, you know, how and also we're gonna find out more about Rachel and stuff like that. Seems that it will have 3 episodes, huh? Alright. Yeah, coming soon. It's a little bit shorter, so, you know, it's kind of like an expansion to Life is Strange. You can think about it that way. But, yeah. Man, Chloe looks so much different. Or looked so much different before she started going into that punk phase or whatever. Alright, let's start. And once again, we have a female protagonist, so, hey. You know, it's not something that you encounter all that often, but, hey, story-based game. Player choice, they will impact the world around you. Choose wisely. They should add, this time you have no, like, comeback mechanism, you know. I mean, there's still, like, save and reload functions, you can, like, tamper with that, but, you know. That looks like a pretty high-speeding train. You might wanna get away from there. Wow, dude, that's so, like, well, happy to see you too, Chloe, but why would you do that?
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Oh, yeah.
Kill me if she knew I was out here.
It really is, Chloe. Yeah, we know for sure, but yeah, that's like... Okay, we're not going back to the train station, train rails, whatever. But yeah, that's like, you know, just think about the life of the fucking train inspector or driver, whatever it's called. Like, he has to, you know, worry like hell that, you know, he might kill someone.
No way.
All right, hold down R and it's a little bit different. You have to, like, use the... you don't drag the mouse to select something. You use, like, the arrow keys to select. Okay.
Holy shit.
You sure this is the right place for you, Chloe? I mean... I know you're into...
This place is awesome.
Never mind.
Old if ship I'm gonna to get move inside, down faster. I'll have to get through that door.
Well, no shit. Machinery, what is this now?
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
Yeah, I wonder that too. So I'm gonna have to, you know, get used to the new controls.
But an old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
Oh shit. Hey, nice.
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Or gay. New dialogue unlocked. Ooh, all right.
Psycho gang. If I had any friends.
Well, now that's death, just sad.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Oh, we can ponder.
Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
Yeah, we know, Chloe, we know. Alright, it seems to go back on the loop, so... ooh, nice RV.
This RV's just begging for a little screwdriver. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
No shit, they're standing like right next to it. What's up?
Those guys need to get a room.
Ooh.
Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
Sure. Ooh, betting stop. Sure, Goldie, 3-1 stake. 0-0, Demonimic. 5-3. Weird. Alright, let's see about getting inside. I suppose we can go just like past the bouncer. No, we have to talk to him. God damn it.
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Damn, look at those earrings. Holy shit.
Help you, miss.
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Fake idea? How would you know?
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Well, you know about that bike, but... Ooh, I have not even seen this door.
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Oh, man. It's different because I'm not really into this kind of stuff, so, you know, it's harder for me to get into character. Ooh, hello. All right.
Now what to draw?
Not the meth lab, sounds good. Man, you don't have any spray paint. Gonna draw with fucking marker. That's so like,
definitely
weak.
Absolutely not a meth lab.
Hey, we have a journal. Look at that. Oh wow. Oh ho. Interesting. All the people we know about. Chloe Price, but you can call me middle finger, alright. Oh my god. Can go through all of this. I'll probably go on my own, you know. Hey, and our little phone book message. Oh, we've been already talking with Frank. Your shit is here. Hell yeah. Tapped out, sorry. You're a loss. Hold it for me for a day, can I? I'm your favorite customer. Are you? Frank, you holding? You still owe. Gonna have me whacked? Yes, please joke about that over text. Deal drugs on this phone. Anyway, come on, it's 420. Meet if you have cash. Ah, Rainneck. Alright. Elliot, who is this? Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I passed. Los Santo. Think I did okay, cool. Why up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Okay. It's just a random guy, he knows. Been bad about email, I think it's better for me anyway. Yo, it's Max, how's it going? Sorry again, I've been really busy. You'd love Seattle more in a bit. Cool. Feature, hey hippie, I'm sorry, maybe we should set up a time to call. Check my dance card. What is it? 2019 in Seattle? Maybe this weekend? It's the latest, Max. Wow, she really did not reply, huh? I wonder why. Be coming home at some point tonight? Nope. Not at all. Alright, let's see if we can convince this guy. With that, you know, info we have about the bike. Hey, listen.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Let me inside now. Wow.
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
I mean, nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Okay, well, you asked for it. You started a backtalk challenge. Whoa, what does that mean?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
Is this like a new mechanic? Like you use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want. Whoa, what? Alright.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
See, pay attention to what your opponent says. Bedtime. Okay. Your bedtime, no bedtime. Do me a solid.
Isn't it past yours?
Oh!
Cute. But I still don't know you.
I showed you my ID card. I don't do cute. Cute is relative, huh?
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Whoa!
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Alright.
Maybe so. I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
They don't need protecting, my bro.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
Oh,
Samoan.
Oh, we got him. We got him good.
Look, my boss decides who gets in, alright?
Okay.
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer.
Nope.
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're alright, kid. Go on in.
That was pretty impressive, man. Gotta say it. Badass Chloe's being badass. There are 3 episodes, I wonder if they're like longer or anything. You know, not that I don't enjoy them, but I have to like keep in check with my recording timer and stuff like that. Okay, let's
this
see what
is intense.
This is all about.
Ophelia,
come.
You dog.
Wow, alright. That's dope. Scream, don't touch my soul with the dirty hands. Question everything. Pastime beer. Well, I mean, on second thought, this looks pretty janky.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Can we pet the pit bull?
What's her name?
Delia.
We know that. There you go.
She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither.
So don't have that one in common. Wow, this girl is just completely
sober up,
passed
girl.
Out.
You're missing the show.
All right.
Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo.
All right. T-shirt vendor. Some guys over here.
Sketch Central.
Beer. Nice. Gonna get. Oh, okay. Gonna get boozed already.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please.
No, thank you. Oh, okay. That's something over there. Oh, we can graffiti the saw. Nobody noticed that.
Sit and spit.
I don't think you actually want to do that. It's pretty dangerous. But I like the idea. Termination note. What? Having recently purchased the Arcadia Marine Corporation as far as the minor position. Foundation looking at all assets. Plan for agreement forbids you from disclosing any company practices or methods of operation, including the detail of this force reduction. Man, the Prescotts.
That's totally me in 5 beers.
So I'm just gonna keep drinking.
Okay, 3.
So you're not that good with alcohol, that's just and freaking fantastic.
Much better.
Yeah. All right. What do we have over here? Oh, okay.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday.
How about you get some brass knuckles? Those look a little bit cooler. You know. This one, something I want to get. Ooh, t-shirts.
$20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
$20, thief.
Oh, alright.
He's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
I mean, $20. I don't know. Do you speak or?
If you have $20, beat it.
Still a dick.
Still a dick, yeah. $20. I mean. Yeah, it's kind of like double the price that you'd expect a t-shirt for.
Yeah, no shit.
I mean,
this car could slide down any minute.
Oh, okay. It depends, you know, on the t-shirt. Well, I can, you know, go in and tamper on.
Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
We're talking about t-shirts at the club, you know.
Shit. No! Come on!
Oh, oops. I ain't just too
Thanks
fucking
for playing,
bad.
Dick.
Alright. How about that t-shirt?
Oh, yeah. Sweet, sweet victory.
Okay, so we drink. We trespass. We steal. Dude, like, let's not go that far.
These guys might burn me at the stake.
I think we already, like, you know, do
Nothing
far enough shit.
Neglected bomb.
Neglected. Alright, let's move on. Oh, we haven't checked the deer head.
Don't you judge me, spooky deer head. I'm here for the band.
Sure, alright, let's try and push through, I
go.
Guess. Oh boy. Pardon me. Excuse me. Sorry. Ouch.
Fuck.
There you go.
Hey. You okay?
I'm fine.
Relax.
Yep.
You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope.
No
don't
fucking
care
idea.
Either.
Let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
Oh.
Right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine.
Oh,
maybe
new
I can
dialogue.
Get a better view of the action from up above.
Oh, we can't really go past,
hey.
Huh? Oh, Frank!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs, you're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm trying to see this damn band. But this place is crazy packed. Hard to get to the stage.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha! The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Who was that guy
I
just pissed off?
That guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Okay.
Where do those stairs go?
Up.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine.
Guess I'll be the first to try.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Oh.
Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye. How about you spot me some? You know I'm good for it.
No way. I learned my lesson last time. Money first.
Never mind, then.
Suit yourself.
Alright, well, it's good to see you, Frank. I'm not gonna steal the money just to get fucking high. As much as Chloe would want that. And I know it's in her character. I think alcohol is good enough as is. Yeah, this doesn't look all that great. Could crash down at any moment.
Fuck, yes! Finally made it! I can't believe it!
Calm down. I hope it's not copyrighted music. It's the last thing I need. Happy to see her enjoying herself, huh? So weird. What if someone saw you?
You spilled my beer, bitch!
Okay. What are these guys doing up here?
It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Okay.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
Okay,
then how
fuck
about
you.
I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Uh-oh.
Hey,
that doesn't look good.
Dickhead.
Oh, interesting. Fuck off.
Ah!
Oh. Ouch.
Rachel?
Oh, that's Rachel.
Come on.
I think it's time to bounce, huh? See ya!
Let me go, Frank! Not gonna happen. Calm down.
Come on, man!
Walk away.
Screw this!
Wow.
Get the fuck out of here!
Good to see Frank is on our side. Oh, we went right back into the concert room. Holy shit. I mean, I knew Rachel was Chloe's friend, but I didn't know she was also that much into, you know, teenage fetishes. I don't know why I call them that way. Ah, finally some nice relaxing music. God damn, I was gonna lose my mind over there. Is this like the Hangover after party? Did we even make it back home? Nice screensaver. This music might be copyrighted, so I should probably be careful. What now? Oh yeah, smoking, of course. This looks like it's already been smoked. Like extinguished and you lit up again. Episode 1, Awake. Huh? Awaking to what? Alright, let's move on. Up, up and away. Do you have like school or anything like that? Assignments?
Sometimes all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
Yeah, don't we all, Chloe? Don't we all? Alright. Put your thoughts in me. Okay, nothing new over here. Now we have like some new data on Frank. Alright, what about this?
Hey Max. Hey Dad. Another day in paradise.
Eggs and bakey. Sounds
last
like the favorite dinner.
Seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber?
Oh, she wasn't friends with her yet.
You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Yeah, that better happen. We can improve the periodic table. Are you gonna discover a new element now? Oh, you're just gonna... Alright, well then. Can't you be more positive? Okay. Switch that off. Ooh, class photo. What do we have here? Hey, Blackwell Academy. Alright. Use the computer. Oh, we can check our emails, huh? Alright, what do we have here? Dear Mr. Gaird, about Firework coming to town. Oh, so that's how we found out about Firework. It's a private party, not as you're not invited, more like you're better off staying away. I know that just made some of you more into it than ever, so proceed at your own risk. Abandon all hope, all you who enter. Ever heard of the meal, Miss Arcadia? That's adorable. Alright. Chloe Price from... Subject: Victoria Chase commented on a guy you're tagged in. Click on the following link. Can I click on the following link? Damn it, I'll have to like check that link or something. Or is this the one? Firewalk jealous. You look hot. Who's the arm candy? Debra something. Debra Borgen. I forget. So fun kisses. Oh man, nice photo. Who's Armand? Chloe Price. And Rachel invited your sleepover night. I was wondering where she was. Burn! Oh, nice one. Alrighty then, let's see about... Oh, we have a skateboard as well.
I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
Is it? Let's see what we have in for today. I mean, we can try the new shirt. Yeah. If we got it, better wear it, right? At least we didn't get any awkward changing clothes transitions. Alright, it's fine. Wait, does that mean that... Oh, fuck. No, it's alright. Then just exit. Okay. Do we also need to like change our pants or?
I really should get going.
Hey, pirate hat.
I bet Long Mac Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago.
Most likely.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome.
I bet it was. Aww, pirate power. DVD with Max. I'm getting all emotional and stuff here. Say, I saved all of this, you have to delete that photo of me dancing, how only you could get me to loosen up like that. Happy 2 month anniversary, enjoy it. Elliot. Mr. Sharky!
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
Oh, fuck. Really?
Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid. But then all the unicorns died.
Can tear it down. Ah, we're gonna leave it. It's fine, let's get going.
Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Oh, don't tell me you lost your phone.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's.
Yeah, that can usually be done. And hopefully it's...
Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Hey, the bathroom. Haven't seen this one in a long time. Hair dye. Oh, yeah. Right. Forgot about that towel. Nothing too interesting over here. Picture. Ooh, Arcadia
home,
Bay.
Sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to.
Alright then. So we're just gonna borrow her phone real quickly. Ooh, drawer. I mean, we're currently scooping in her.
Mom!
Oh! Nice. Alright, don't think I needed to know that, but fine.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
We don't have time for this now, man. You don't need to put it in your ear, you're just calling your own phone. And that is...
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
In the bathroom? Oh, in the fucking... garbage.
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Yeah, probably not too many. Or at least one. Oh, just a message from Elliot. Not a problem. Okay, you finished the Chem homework? Nope. Dude, that's the third time. I already know everything. Do you now? By curfew, there will be consequences. Your action will have confiscated.
Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah. Okay.
We have our...
You saw Mom's purse in her room?
We have our, like, bruise from the punch. I wonder if that's gonna be, like, the consequence. Purse. Necklace. Drawer.
I hate that man. She hides all our old pictures of Dad.
What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend?
I think it's the other way around. Wow, okay.
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
Ooh. Why is an Illuminati sign? What? I suppose that's the, you know, your action will have consequences sign, but why? Why is it the Illuminati thing? Oh, there's the purse. There we go.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married.
Yeah, no need to do that anytime soon. Insurance value, cash value, store credit value. Sure, let's get going. Spent enough time over here.
Coming, Mom.
Yeah. God damn. It's good to be back. In good ways and bad.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
If we hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
So we still need to go to school, huh? There you go. You're welcome.
I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
I think she already does. Shipyard closing. It's pretty nasty. Wildfire warning. Tuition hike. Huh. It's all doom and gloom over here. Hey, the swear jar.
That's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Damn.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth?
Oh, well. Yeah, Joyce, Mom.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Yeah.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Guess this is what we're talking about.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that. Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewalk? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled?
Right.
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David could help?
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself.
David
thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
I mean, this is something Chloe would say, but yeah, I don't know.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
Well,
what takes you to school today?
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Interesting. Let's, I mean, already been to a fucking night party. Let's be understanding.
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
Oh boy.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Why? Yeah, we can shake the thing. Damn, son. I don't think you need that much oomph in it.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Sure is. Hey, that's a lot of stuff here. Oh, we still have that spilled mark.
From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me. Or it's because we can't afford nice things.
That might be it. Support our vets, trash, mails.
Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
There's quite a bunch of them. This color square.
Family pic used to hang here. I can't actually remember which one.
Sad. Okay, where is that ash? Oh, there it is.
Here they are.
Pick them up! It's like you picked up shit. God damn it. Okay, let's...
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going.
Yeah, I'm very good going. Not want to get be late on top of the fact that you have to do all this. Photos.
Took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
Come on. Hey, Steph. This is Steph Grinch. Ginrich. Hey, have your DVD. You can get it before school. Thanks. Is it before school? Oh, well then.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Been out 2 seconds.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
Oh, come on, don't start.
You men will leave without us.
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron.
Is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Okay.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
Well then.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket.
Sorry, I cut through the dialogue, but. You know?
What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something?
I guess we should fill her in. Her mom's gonna get married to David. I know. It's pretty bad, but it's gonna happen. Now I can look through all this stuff.
Do they even make film for these anymore?
And we will give it to,
Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache.
Aw, man.
David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted.
Maybe it's over here then. She has something written on her palm. Is that it? Suppose it is.
50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
Calm down! God damn, dude, it's so... I mean, yeah, we already know this. Here you go.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
He's not making it easy on us, either. That's the... real kicker.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
So we're good to go. I'm gonna have some more peep talk over here. It's killing me, man. It's killing me. I'm doing it for the others, you know. For Chloe, for her mother, for David.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
What was that laugh? Did you just laugh at our toolbox? think that's a safe point.
Roll.
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
We can shut this down, huh? Ignore and endure. Huh, fine.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
It's easier said than done.
See if part of what David's saying makes sense to me.
Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
Once again, it's a little bit weird thinking about it. Just like those episodes from Walking Dead, they take a small break over here and come like that. But just like the episodes from Walking Dead, it's, you know, those that were in the past, it's like weird that you can take choices that will affect the future, but we already know what happened, and that doesn't change no matter what we choose. So, once again, your choices do matter, but not entirely, you know, that's like the part about it. I'll be back in a bit. Alright, we're back. Oh, yeah, we were driving and stuff.
Country music? Dad loved this song.
How about that?
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my friend.
Cool.
What a beautiful day.
Yeah, isn't it? Oh, it's actually... Oh, she's having a dream?
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
Says that it's William here.
If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Interesting.
This isn't right.
Wait, is she gonna dream about the accident?
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
Yeah. Damn. I knew it was coming. It will only make sense that way. Interesting that they changed the loading drawing animations. You know, it's a bird. The one that where your action will have consequences is like an Illuminati sign for some whatever reason. But hey. So far, so good.
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Yeah, we dozed off a bit. All right, so.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello. I was actually saying.
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Right. I know it's not in Chloe's nature, but you know, I'm trying my best to mediate things, even though we all know how things eventually end up, so begs the question, what's the point of doing it, right? Might as well just go crazy and back talk everyone. Good luck, seniors, huh? Future needs excellence. Alright, let's see what's different around here. The students should be mostly the same. The only difference was that unlike Max, I'm not sure how many of them knew or liked Chloe. Oh, there's that guy.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
God damn what? It.
This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know, haters on social media.
Goddamn haters, man.
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
Maybe? This guy doesn't seem in her league, but...
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
You sure?
Right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
We didn't see this guy in the... I don't remember, Elliot? It doesn't sound familiar. I don't think he was
gotta track
back
down
there.
Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
You sure? Press and hold your objective. Wow, we write our objective on our hand. Alright, well.
Maybe this play won't suck.
Remember I did that a few times. It's like not forget things, but yeah. Drugs, they will mess you up. Hell yeah, they will. And what's this sci-fi movie club? In the genre, let us introduce you to this classic. For movie suggestions, see Warren or Brooke. Of course, the two geeks. Hey! Picnic tables with Mikey, thanks. On my way. Yeah, I know some of the abbreviations.
The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole.
How can you know? Hey, Victoria.
Oh, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography. Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever.
She is still a bitch, isn't she?
That, what with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Yeah.
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
Yeah, we saw it. We murdered a man. No, we didn't. What?
Tell what, Victoria? It's a photo. Big deal.
But it's on Facebook! I mean, that basically means you and Rachel are like BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it
interesting.
Drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Wow.
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber.
Ooh.
That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
And she wants some gossip.
I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh.
Oh. How can you sabotage that homework?
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course. That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey, thanks, Carrie.
It's Chloe.
No problem.
Well, she just wrote those down and those were answers. My god, the way she walks! Ah, when I saw sabotage, I thought she was gonna pick her homework and throw it in the fountain. That's, you know, a little bit less bad, but still. Can she believe she actually fell for it? Alright, so she said that she's somewhere at the picnic or whatever. Probably there. There's also this guy. Oh, Ivan! What's up with this young fellow over here?
I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Oh, God.
To you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
Okay. Wildfires are awesome.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
Now I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
What? Really?
Say knobcone again.
No.
Knobcone?
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
Huh.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone.
Cool.
Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess.
Ask her, no, ask me.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Petition again. Nah, anything to get out of class.
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
I'm not, dude. Did
you
just
to change my mind?
Did you just hear what I said?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
Heavens, and ass clown smoke with the bear.
Happy to support such an important cause.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for signing my petition. Smoke weed, de bear?
Only you can prevent ganja fires.
Sorry, dude. I had to. You're asking for too much from me, alright? Hey, what's going on over here?
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill
challenge? Oh, D&D?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner, director's cut, coming right up.
Yep.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was like a friend thing?
I don't know. It's so weird, like, we got, like, a phone with Rachel Amber, now everyone assumes that we are, like, BBFs. BFFs.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
Fine.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
I'm actually curious to play this
Here's
game myself.
A character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Uh-huh.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred.
Nice.
As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, Wizard of the Third Circle,
foremost advisor to King Tiberius and sworn defender of Avernum.
Okay. This is a
us. Introduce your character.
Oh, yeah, God.
Okay. I'm an elf barbarian named... Calamastia.
Sounds good enough.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes...
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
Ooh. Smay the man a kebab. A man kebab.
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him too. True story.
All right.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Yeah.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie.
Nah, dude, just go for this. Just go straight for that guy.
It's tent time.
Are you sure you want to skip the training ground and the prison camp?
100%.
You heard me. Let's do the boss battle.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders.
Oh my god, it's huge!
Sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha.
Need more work on your
lands
voice acting.
Your people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Calamastia? What'll it be?
Throw an axe right here. Wrathful Rush.
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry... angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge.
Yeah.
Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Nice.
Hell yeah.
Next.
Guess that's his term. Brutal punch.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
Like. Right in the
dick.
Right in the dick.
Fuck around the
pussy. You miss. Durgaron burst out laughing as he stumbled past him.
Asshole.
Damn.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
Let's finish him off.
Holy shit. Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
One?
Wow.
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural, severing both feet at the ankles.
This game is awesome.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit.
Oh, you're dead, son.
This was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp. Stomp. Stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Yeah, jump in front of him. Dance.
I don't know. Shit. I dance to distract him.
You dance?
Yeah, dude.
Distract him.
I'm doomed.
16? What?
What?
Your crappy arrhythmic dancing is weirdly mesmerizing. He pauses with his sword in midair for 10 seconds. Buying Elmon time to crawl away.
Nice.
Okay. Durgeron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
And...
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgeron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
I've seen that in Dark Souls.
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgeron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I can still do something. Swing where he said.
I take one last swing at Durface's head.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Oh no.
Yeah.
11. You swing, catching Durgeron on the side of his head, severing one horn, but you don't do enough damage to kill him. He laughs, then rips you off his sword with a vicious jerk. You die painfully.
Oh well.
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to escape.
Hey man, if you can, do it.
I cast Warden's Hideaway.
You sure?
It's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgeron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight and cannot be harmed.
I guess I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
And when you change your spells, dude.
That was
wow.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
That's pretty good.
Sorry I died and left you out there to fend for yourself.
It's cool. I'll get him.
Man, I want to play this game in real life, dude.
Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
Sounds like fun, but you need a lot of time to play it.
Thanks for the game.
And you need all those special dices and character sheets, and you need someone to actually, like, make
check.
The story.
Next stop, chemistry class.
Joy.
You know? It is pretty difficult to make something like that. That's what I'm trying to say. Alright, then let's go and see for chemistry. Who the fuck are you?
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
I don't know. I haven't read it myself.
The story is about how relationships only work if people are willing to lie to each other.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually...
Aww.
Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet.
Hey, that was weird. Really strange, but anyway, hey, wildfire danger.
This makes being high sound like a bad thing.
we are it's high, get it. Hey, dangers of wildfire, and not actually read like what it says there, because why the hell would we be able to do that? Alright, let's do, hey, watch out. Is
what
that
you got here, Twitch? Don't call me that.
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the class. List. That's just one more.
Oh wow.
God, that
this
was
is
weird.
Really weird crap, Prescott. It's not yours. Give it back. I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
Oh.
The mute speaks?
Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Oh.
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
Nothing to me to do about it.
I'm going to do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
Oh, that's my idea.
A piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop. Chloe, do something. Don't just stand there watching.
Her voice is so high. Ah, fine.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
I don't know why I'm doing this.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Wanna try the back talk again. Back off?
Back off? As in, go away? No one's interested in your crap.
Oh.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
Congrats. You've actually got me feeling sorry for Arcadia Bay's most spoiled brat. That's how much of an asshole you're being right now.
Ooh. You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
You have no idea how crazy I am. Keep pushing and find out.
You want a piece of this?
Oh.
Please. Kicking your ass is going to be a piece of cake.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
With words.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
You shut the fuck up.
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
Wow.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Hey. What's up?
Everything okay here?
Yeah.
No problem, Skip.
No, it's different guy. Interesting that he backed down from just words. Hey. Me too, I know you're doing your best, love you. That is just so nice. Alright, let's get on with this. Hello? Oh!
Oh, good. You're here.
Excuse me? Wow, she really wants a piece of my ass, Rachel Amber. I don't know.
I do beseech you. Chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What
beseech?
Is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father. I have broke your hest to say so.
Hest?
Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues... hath I listened to...
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit. Rachel looks awesome.
Yeah,
this is
does.
Getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean... Does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
Why are you looking at me? What?
The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Idiot.
Miranda's an idiot because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
Actually, she's about 15, so your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive, is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
So.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
Yeah.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay.
Thanks for stepping in.
Why am I here again?
A bigger question is why.
For me? Yeah. I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah. Sure.
Why is she hitting on us? That's the bigger question over here.
Get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right?
What's this? Yeah, we already know that. Tempest playing Prospera, Nathan Prescott playing Caliban. Alright, Miranda playing Ferdinand, playing Ariel, directing. Alright. Well, not interested into theater and shit, so. Poster. What is
this? This poster definitely says something.
It says Quell. Ooh, hello.
RA will suck as Prospera. If VC had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you? Slut?
Oh.
Guess they don't call it Drama Lab for nothing.
We can comment as well. Fuck yeah. Where's our marker? They're right up our ass, as
what
always.
To say? What to say?
Slut shaming? Yeah, it's nothing conspicuous to look around like that.
Is so 2009. VC should know.
Huh. Alright, now let's search for that belt. Nice bag. Huh?
Rachel looks so happy here.
Suppose.
There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now.
This is getting more and more interesting as
Tons
time goes on.
Hard for elite private high schools.
Pens and fun. Hey,
if
nice
I'd
props.
Known acting meant getting to play with weapons, I totally would have auditioned for the Tempest.
There
should be
models.
Life is drama.
What? Drama is life. Yeah, life is drama. Okay. Ooh, hello.
Must be 100 costumes in here. Am I the only student who's not in this show?
We can graffiti the poster. Yeah, let's leave our mark everywhere. Horns for Nate on Nathan. Yeah. Beware of wild animals. Oh, I am the wildest animal you can see, baby. Except for maybe Rachel Amber, who's like, holy shit,
just
next level. Yep. Alright, what's this? Here are all the pencils, I know it was you. Okay, and then I are very beautiful on the go out. I would be into that. Logan, guess who? Wow, okay. Meager attempts.
Rachel?
Is this your belt?
Yes. Thank you.
Okay. I guess I shall just bring the... Oh. Yeah, just close your eyes. It's fine.
More belt.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So,
nice cover up.
My dressing room?
How about a belt instead?
Perfect.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Yeah. Is this something similar to, like, The Last of Us, the DLC for The Last of Us?
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
Sure was.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Maybe it doesn't have to end.
Exactly. How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
This is Rachel Amber gone rogue?
Ditch class. You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's not.
No, it's awesome.
I hoped you'd say that. Now about that eye, that is a hell of a battle scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
Sure.
Yes, please. People won't shut up about
exactly.
It.
I wouldn't mind too much if not everyone that we encounter is like, oh, what happened to you? Oh, what's that? Oh, did you not sleep well? Oh, did you get in a... Oh, no. Whatever.
Hold still.
It hurts. Probably.
This is a lot of makeup.
That's the price of valor. Close your eyes.
Such a close up to her face.
Much better.
Yeah. Doesn't.
Holy shit.
Look like a thing.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Ooh, did you just slap us? Slap her ass. I'm losing my words over here. What's going on between these two girls? I think it might be deeper than you know what I initially thought.
You don't want to just grab the bus, or
nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right.
What? We're grabbing the train? Where the hell are we going to go?
Well,
what the hell am I getting into here?
Holy shit. Drop it, up it, up it, and up we go.
Where does this thing go?
Yeah, that's a good what? Question.
Maybe we'll end up in Seattle.
That'll be cool.
Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
I mean, it is, but...
Rachel wants me to pull up
a chair. Hey, why weren't you in cam? Everything okay? Yep. We drew some people saying you were awesome. Yo, let's talk later, okay?
Maybe one of these crates.
Hey, more symbols.
Guess we're not the first ones to hop on this train. I wonder what the symbols mean.
Shipping labels? Maybe we can find out where this goes. Notice of termination from Scott Prescott Foundation. Now that's pretty nasty. Hey, you can use this crate to sit down. Alright, let's just push it there. Hey, careful not to push it up. Sure is.
I guess I should sit down.
Yes, you should. Yep.
All right, Chloe.
You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool.
Yeah, like, what does she see at us?
Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Should I answer here so I could ask? Should I make small talk? Is that what people do?
Yeah, you could. Nice weather. That's perfect. That's totally me.
What is wrong with you? What? You're acting nervous. So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging
out. You noticed?
Because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends. You have friends. Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures. That sucks.
Sure does.
Hey, so, I want to say thanks for pulling you out of school.
More for last night.
Thanks for last night. If you hadn't shown up.
Yeah.
Assholes abound in Arcadia Bay. I owe you. That's for sure. Is that why you came along? Are you suggesting I should need a reason to ditch school? I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, I wanted some company. That's it? That's it. Good to fucking go. Anything beats another second in Blackwall. You really hate it there, don't you? You don't? Right. What reason would Rachel Amber have for hating Blackwell Academy? Your high school royalty. You don't know me.
Oh.
Yet.
Oh.
Let's do something fun.
Okay. It's a little bit close to... What?
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry. Wow. Too far? Okay, something fun. I'm all ears. Two truths and a lie.
Oh, I have to guess.
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts. Two are true. And one of which is a lie.
And you have to guess which is which.
And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Alright, sure.
Sounds fun. You're on.
Who did Chloe did it with? I'm sorry.
I'll start.
It's weird.
First, I'm ambidextrous.
The fuck does that mean?
Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end. New York, huh? I've never been.
Mm-hmm.
Not a world traveler? Not yet, at least.
Not money.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
Kathmandu? One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
That's a pretty heavy proposition.
From Arcadia Bay was ambitious.
Yeah.
What's your third thing? My third thing? Two truths and a lie. You say three things. Right. I'm a Leo. Meow. Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo.
She does seem like a Leo.
So, which is the lie?
I don't know what ambidextrous means. What the hell? Just wait a second. Just a bit. Don't run away or anything. Ambidextrous. Instead of being equally adapted in the use of both the left and the right hand. Only 1% of the people are actually ambidextrous. Oh, so, you know, left-handed, right-handed, and she's with both. Ah, interesting. I think it's a lie about New York.
You seem more like a Cali girl to me. Damn, Bryce, not bad. Long Beach, in fact. West Coast is the best coast. I've only ever lived in Oregon, so nothing to compare it to, I guess. Then we'll have to change that one day, won't we? Okay, your turn, Bryce.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game.
Let's start with the truth, I guess.
I used to want to be a pirate when I grow up. I kinda still do.
Arr. Okay, let's go for a lie. He's not in a band, so...
I'm secretly the lead guitarist of an all-girl Misfits cover band called The Misfits.
Impressive.
I think that's very easy to put out. Maybe...
I love science. Seriously, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the shit.
Huh.
Alright, let's see.
You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella? Who says that?
It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. Of course you wanted to be a pirate. Sail the open seas.
Okay, she gets that one.
Plunder secret treasure.
Did I mention my love of booty?
So, pirate. Obviously true.
Okay.
Like you said. Arr.
Yeah, you have to be more impressive. Arr!
Okay. You say you love science, but you are failing chemistry.
You're saying failing chemistry means I hate science?
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best work?
That place is a hellhole filled with shit, where shitty people go to be shitty to each other and themselves.
Tell me how you really feel, though. Anyway, school sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true.
Okay.
So, let's talk about this lead guitarist business.
The business of show.
As much as I'd love to be a groupie to your all-girl cover band, The Misfits, I'm gonna have to call a lie on that one.
You don't think I can rock?
On the contrary, you absolutely rock. The problem is, your hand is smooth. No
calluses.
You don't play guitar.
Right.
Pity too. You'd look hot on stage. So, if my math is correct, you told me two truths and one lie.
This bumping.
You expected me to cheat?
Winners make their own rules, Chloe.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one.
Sure.
When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Interesting. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey. Thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game. And not everyone would admit to wanting to be a pirate.
But eye patches are so cool.
And rum is delicious. I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but
Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
No, oh, I'll give you that idea.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
So, are we going to get back, or...?
I wouldn't mind listening to some music.
Keep riding this train to wherever the hell it goes? Okay, that's...
Hey, wanna listen?
It would be rude to just pop your both your earplugs and just listen alone after she's like next to you and done all that. And I feel that this is another copyrighted music, so this... I basically think this episode is gone to shit from a monetization perspective, but hey! At least I'm enjoying myself. Okay, okay, I'll leave, you don't have to bug me like that. That was pretty short music. Oh, wait, just a second. Alright, let's see where this ride takes us.
Bracelet. I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach. Or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
Yeah.
Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks.
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day...
Oh...
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
It's like
check
a premonition.
We're here!
We're... where?
What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump!
Fuck off.
No way! Scared? That's not the Chloe Price I know. Trust me, this is the only Chloe Price there.
Well, shit. At least you can get a heads up or something. You're jumping off of a moving train. Want to jump a little bit farther away so you don't end up right under under it. And then if you can run on the train and then jump so you can like match the speeds so you don't just go from moving directly stationary. It's, you know, it's basic physics, but of course. Why would you know about this? Fucking playing Kerbal Space Program on my own and on my lists. What is this place now? Is that a lighthouse? Looks like the place where it will be the lighthouse. It was not built yet? That's interesting. Pretty far away that you have to take the train to get all the way here. those totems. Still a thing.
Hey, it's actually a pretty nice view.
It is.
And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Another one?
Another one. I like games. Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
Medium tech at most, but whatever. Is that in the process of firing it up, or...
that blows. Well, shit.
So it happens when you don't read the signs.
You. Quarterless. Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh, yeah?
MacGyver.
Let's see what you got.
Oh. Hello. Sorry about you. Not your fault. Brother's not always an asshole. Oh, it's his brother. Just most of the time. Forget it.
Okay. Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her.
Hmm.
Huh. Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool.
Oh, look at that. Probably not with my hands.
I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use.
Yo.
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
Not sure if it's strong enough, but we could try.
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file. Oh, right. Sure, let's try it.
Oh, come on, what's... Chloe Price in carbon potassium uranium? You don't know that spells fuck you on the periodic table? Roll for that, you carbonate uranium nitrogen. Call me cunts, huh? Tennis SN. Oh, that was a good one. Nice.
Damn it. It always looks so easy in the movies. Wonder if I can find something sturdier to use.
Something sturdier, you say? How about my diamond crowbar, maybe? Bench. Squirrels. Hey, can scare them away.
Get out of here, woodland creatures. Have some self-respect.
No, birds came instead. What a difference. Initials.
I've been saying sorry all morning. I admit it was really dumb to lock the keys in the car. You've been on me for 3 hours.
Hey guys. Do you have a coin? You have some change? Transformation. Interesting stuff.
Hey, spare some change?
Sorry, we might have some leftover food when we're done.
What? No, I'm not. What kind of food?
This place has really gone downhill.
Shh. She's right there.
There's the wine. Not exactly something to pry open stuff with.
My hierarchy of needs goes pot, then beer, then wine. Still, wino has a classy ring to it.
There are the initials. Well, I've checked over here, I guess. Dedication plate, I did not see that one. We can unscrew it. Why would I do that? Oh, we can use it to like pry it open, right? It's a little bit sturdier.
Stealing Martin Lewis a dedication press plate takes persistence.
you say? Gray jays. I can scare those as well. Huh. Wait, message. Steph, Oh my god, so much. Thanks on my heads up. Wells is on the warpath. Oh no, seriously, just trying to help. Kill me this morning with that GM dude. Also, thanks for playing with us. He's cool. Okay, glad I could help, I guess. So weird, like you're trying to get into the character, but you're also trying to be yourself when you're playing it, so you create this weird combination. Come on, dude. There you go. There it is. Just gently yank it out there, and we did it. Is this one out of order, or...? Game over.
I don't want to boast, so I'll let you do it for me.
Chloe Price, you are truly the Viewfinder Whisperer. I stand in awe of your powers.
Very good. So?
Rachel smells like jasmine? Is she smelling me right now too? Really should have showered this morning.
Here's
the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it. I do that in my head during, like, every class.
See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
There's a grill there. Now look at that.
Loving this guy. What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful. In its own way.
It is. Alrighty then. Hey. What about these guys?
What's going on with these two?
Ooh, I'm kinda running out of deep space. Child sacrifice, holy shit.
And the Lord saideth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Huh.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
Son, now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started. Further. Further.
Oh, wow.
Wow. That was dark.
It was.
Dark. Perfect dark.
Alright. Alright. Sorry for that. Small interruption. Should be good to go.
Sweet beanie. What do you suppose she's thinking?
Nature's Wi-Fi sucks.
Nature's Wi-Fi sucks.
Maybe there's a squirrel family around here with broadband.
Oh, yeah.
If only I can guess their password. We love nuts, 69. Those ate our babies, 13. Too soon.
We love nuts, 69. I think that's... That might be a real username for something.
This is fun. Who's next? Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder.
What are those guys doing? A little bit laggy, but... Aww.
Jackpot! It's makeout session in 3, 2, 1... Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it.
And you are watching. Prostitutes, what?
Oh, honey. I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double.
Rachel?
Oh, where did she... What? That's hey. Someone you know?
Are you alright?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party? Be my guest.
How gracious of you.
I'm gonna convince them to borrow the wine.
They have a bottle of wine.
I know.
Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And...
is that how it works? It.
I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
I am so confused right now.
Can we help you? Oh my god!
Holy shit. Talk about committing to a performance.
She really does, huh?
Better act fast.
Well, we're just gonna... you know, swipe that. Hello.
Oh, thank God. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
Okay.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go!
Don't look at me. Look at Baywatch over here. Aw, I don't remember how to do CPR. Wah. It's time to nut up or shut up.
Oh.
Watch out. I'm going to check her pulse. That's on her neck, right?
I still think you should go get help. There's a ranger station on the other side of the park.
Good point. We'll keep watch while you go.
Look at all the time we've wasted already. This woman needs mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Stat.
No.
Yep. Definitely needs mouth-to-mouth.
Okay. Okay. You can do this. I can't do it.
Pathetic. Look, he's clearly useless. This woman needs help from someone who actually knows what they're doing.
Unlock your potential.
Look at me. Do you want to be locked out of the car of life forever? Or are you ready to break in there and seize the keys to your potential?
Oh my god.
Wow, that's crazy. Alright, I'll take the wine and just go. Oh god, no.
Hey, wow, I'm all better now. You saved my life. From the bottom of my heart, thank you.
Yeah, good work everyone. Peace out.
They're not noticing that we just took the wine.
That was incredible. You're a hero.
Huh. I guess I am.
Oh, wow. Quite a dramatic performance. Jesus. Whoa, easy there.
Here, you earned this.
Thanks.
Once again, trying to play in character, not something that I would necessarily do myself.
I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
Are you going to finish that whole bottle at once? I mean, it's not vodka, so it's not that strong, but still.
I am excessively sober right now.
Excessively
right.
Sober.
Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
Something is happening, I don't know. Yeah. Wow. That, you know, quite changes the perspective of things dramatically. A little bit. So we knew they were friends, but I didn't know that, you know, Rachel was the one, you know, to go first for it. Such a direct fashion. What I wanted to say is that, you know, in the DLC for The Last of Us, I forgot what it's called. It's also like, you know.
Whoa. Hey, check this out.
Two girls. Yeah, I'm forgetting the name. They end up together and shit. Like, and I'm wondering if this game is also trying to draw a reference to, like, you know, LGBTQ issues and stuff like that. You know, it's something that it's growing and awareness is spreading. Not everyone in the world thinks the same, obviously, and there'll be arguments both sides, but it allows us to see things from a different perspective.
Yeah, an awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe. I'm gonna go sit down.
Oh, look at that.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's something about the guys that are... that kissed.
I've heard that actors are moody, but... wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that alright with you?
Okay. Actually... no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Alright.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Well, then make me. Okay.
Okay. I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that.
You sure? Next thing you know, the...
score.
Oh, I get it. We're gonna smash some shit.
Hey, check it out.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run!
I thought you were gonna smash it.
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Oh.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait. Don't go. Why not?
Because I love you.
Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly?
Oh.
Fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it?
Say what exactly?
You know, like a friendship. But more.
Ah.
I know. Weird, right? It's just... today was the best day I've had since... since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize... whatever's going on between us is special.
It just happened between us in, like, the past one day.
Come on. Say something. Chloe, I... you know what? Forget it. This was really stupid. I mean, you're Rachel Amber, and I'm Chloe Price.
It's not that. It's just hard right now. And I can't talk about it.
Why not? Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is.
No.
Goodbye, Chloe.
Damn. A sad way to end an episode. Everything was going so well. What the hell? Time to smash things up, huh?
Fuck this place.
Oh yeah. Smash. All the options are smash. Wow. Look at that.
You know she's fake. You can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description? Yeah! Fuck off, Rachel.
Damn.
I've never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras.
Alright then. Anything else? Oh, she's calling. I think you know I have a meeting tomorrow, Principal Wells. I need you to do better. Chloe? Oh god. Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just smashing things up, Mom. Don't worry about it. Good kiddos. Okay, well then. Ooh, the toolbox.
If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David.
Well. Teenage anger. I mean, remember being angry myself, but I don't remember ever like smashing things up, multiple repeated things. Oh man. Oh, it's his car. Just getting from sad to sadder. Why do you play with my emotions, game? I didn't came here for a feels trip. Yeah, you smashed him good. Pretty hard to survive that. Though I've seen worse. Technically. Smash it. Why? All right, fine. Just and it's done. Oops, sorry. I think this has been it. Life is strange before. Oh, there's one more scene. Wait. Life is Strange before is The Storm, episode 1. Quite the field trip. I'm gonna go through this again.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Aww. What the fuck?
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on? What's past is prologue and shit.
Yeah, they're the same.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
Yeah? Seemed pretty upset when I left her, but I guess. Fucking graffitied, wow.
Hey, where's my marker?
Oh, don't have it, huh?
I guess I did that.
Even the dream scenes are interesting.
That was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say? She nearly took your head off.
Are we going in circles, or...?
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
Oh. There it is.
Oh, the marker.
Sometimes, people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
What the fuck? There's some strong symbolism behind that. Ouch. Like, you know, fire because it's going away, fire because, you know, the burning passion of what this relationship might be. Hey, we just fell asleep in the car, huh? Is it too late to go home now? Sad story, man. It's really sad. You know, I already know, you know, because I played the first game, I already know, like, the backstory, and that's why I'm not that, you know, surprised about it, but still sad. That doesn't change that. And it's time to go back. Pretty long walk considering that it took the train to get here. Still more, huh? Oh, you're gonna meet up and, you know, say you're sorry and make friends again?
Okay. I'm glad. Hey, I couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe,
I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about
it. Spit it out, mate.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree?
I know it was something about that.
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh, look at that.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
Oh, so that's why we actually played the game, huh?
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
Kind of a mixed feeling.
My dad died. I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining.
Oh.
And I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat and how calm he was and the sound of his voice and
No. Okay.
He was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Don't worry about it.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that.
Blind.
Like, blind desperation.
Yeah.
And maybe a slight buzz from that wine.
Yep.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? You dropped that one guy with a bottle to the face.
Only because you showed up at the last minute and...
What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet, actually.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
But then we're gonna get in trouble.
Tomorrow, they'll be hell to pay.
Yeah.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever. Okay.
Tomorrow it is, then. I'm not the one to argue about financial stability and shit like that.
Can I borrow your lighter?
I suppose that's the... why we saw her burning in the dream. And throw it in the garbage can, there might be more flammable stuff in there, and then those will light up and cause an even greater fire. Well... yeah, just what I said! Starting fires all over the place in the forest, just like... God damn it, why do I have to be the only logical mind when playing video games? So... Jesus. Yeah, you're done goofed now. This is a... that thing is gonna spread, man, you better run now. Intense, man. Intense emotions. Talking about premonitions. Congrats, you start another forest fire. Job well done. Fucking anyway. Yeah. A very pack-filled emotional episode. There's nothing to argue against that. And you know, even without the time travel ability, I do feel like this was actually even better, because I feel like, you know, the thing is about the ability in the previous game is that it didn't really change much. You can change the choice, like, you know, right before, but in the grand scheme of things, nothing changes, you know, and you cannot go back that much anyway. You can only go back to, like, change one choice, and you basically have control over the immediate result, but not over the long-term one, so... big deal. Well, this long episode of Darkness is getting pretty awkward. I was expecting the credits to roll and something like that, but I guess the game just prefers to let me hear and sit and talk about nothing. Well, anyway, it's probably going to happen. I can watch the credits on my own and you can too. It's not really that important. The only problem might be that there might be some sort of like after credits scene. There usually is one. I'm not sure. We'll see. Well, anyway, hope you guys enjoyed watching. Make sure to leave a like, subscribe to see more, and I'll see you next time. What are you going to make? Good episode, as always. They have not failed to disappoint so far, at least.